4 on 106.3 Dance Radio. Dance Radio.
Prepare yourself.
Ang sinig aralan sa radyo, hating dahil ay makabagong paraan ng pagtuturo at kalaman. Mapaumaga, tanghali o hapon na yan, ang istasyon magbibigay impormasyon kahit sa man.
For something big.
Alright, here we go.
106.3 Dance Radio. Doña Aurora National High School, Santa Rita, Aurora, Isabela.
This
106.3 DWBR-FM. Calculus, Advanced Algebra, Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry, Elementary Algebra, Geometry. Maaari rin dapat ito kasi Mathematics Learning Area. Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan. Mathematics, maaasahan inyong tututukan dito sa 106.3 DWDR-FM. Basta Dance Radio, learning is amazing!
Kalagayan ngayon sa panahong ito. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat, lalo na sa ating mga mag-aaral. Huling linggo na ng ating aralin. Kaya't sana kayo'y makinig at sumali sa amin. Saya at aral ang handog namin kapag pinalad ka, may load pang kakantin. O, diba? Okay, medyo... Oo, may naririnig akong gumagaya sa akin. Okay. Welcome to Math Alive sa Facebook Live! O, diba? Meron nga akong naririnig na tunog, ano? Okay! It's Monday, November 8, 2021. Ito po ang ika-apat na RVI live streaming para sa shift to...
Wala, mag-ganon!
Meron ako naririnig talaga.
Magsishare ako yun.
Yes. Malapit-lapit na po pagtatapos mga anak. Ano? Konti-konti na lang. Kaya sana mag-join at sumali na kayo sa ating huling week. Patuloy na inaayahan po natin lahat ng mga grade levels. Grade 7, grade 9, and grade 10. Kung kayo ay medyo chill lang dyan at wala kayong masyadong ganap, manood at mag-join kayo at matuto, di ba? Dahil ang live streaming po ito ay para sa ating mga mag-aaral, para kahit hindi tayo nagkikita-kita ay maibahagi namin sa inyo, maipaliwanag ang mga aralin na kailangan nyong malaman. Tayo po ay nasa week 4 ng ating Mathematics 8. Parang hindi naririnig ko yung sarili ko. Okay, ikalawang live discussion na po, kaya sana manood kayo at makibahagi ngayong araw. Binabati po natin lahat ng magulang na nanonood dyan ano, at nakikinig. Hello! Good morning po sa aking Nanay Lena and of course sa aking Trevor and Elijah and to my Bebe. O, diba? So, since binati na din natin lahat ng gusto natin batiin, good morning po sa lahat ng teachers ng math learning area, no? Kumusta po kayo dyan sa bahay? Good morning, Sir Sari. Magpalakas ka, ha? Hello. Hello, Ma'am Cora, Ma'am Delma, Ma'am Marife, Ma'am Marin, Ma'am Marley, Ma'am Naida, Ma'am Mardi. O, di ba? Baka may hindi ako mapanggit sa lagot tayo. Hello sa mga anak ko, 7 City, 7 Kultura, kung nandiyan kayo. Hello, good morning. And of course, sa lahat ng grade 8, ano, batiin natin sila. SPJ, SPA, Copernicus, Aristotle, Socrates, Aquamarine, Burgundy, Beige, hello mga Beige, Crimson, Cyan, Ivory, Tangerine, Purple, maroon and lavender. Good morning! Yours truly is Ma'am Gawela S. Santos at ang aking partner, of course, si Ma'am Jen. Go, go, go!
Hello, hello, hello! Naririnig po ba ako?
Yes!
Okay. So, isang napakagandang umaga sa lahat ng ating mga listeners and viewers dyan. Hello sa inyong lahat! Siyempre, nais ko kayong i-welcome sa ating Math Alive sa Facebook Live. Ayan! Narito na naman kami upang magbigay kaalaman sa inyo, mga minamahal naming mga learners. Kaya naman, mula sa inyong co-host for today, isang mainit na pagbati sa aking mga grade 8 lavender at grade 8 maroon. Hi mga anak, sana ay nakatutok kayo sa mga oras na to. Okay, at huwag kayong aalis sa ating istasyon hanggang sa matapos ang ating live streaming. So, fourth week na nga natin ngayon, gaya ng sabi ng aking partner na si Ma'am Ella. So, ibig sabihin, etong Kembot na lang na to at next week ay academic is na.
Wow.
Ayan, masaya.
Sana okay. Ay talaga.
So, binabati ko din ang mga grade 7 Jacinto, 7 Lapu-Lapu at syempre special mention ng aking mga mahal na 7 Del Pilar. Hello sa inyong anak, hello sa inyong lahat mga anak. Siyempre, binabati ko din ang mga pamangkin kong masisipag mag-aral, aral ng mabuti. So, sa lahat ng mga nag-aabang at umaantabay sa ating programa, saan mang sulok ng mundo, hello sa inyong lahat. So, mga anak naming grade 8, makinig, manood at makibahagi sa ating talakayan ngayon. Okay, siyempre, maganda ang ating lesson for today. Siyempre, hindi natin makakalimutang batiin at pasalamatan si Ma'am Larna Tan Nevado. Hello, ma'am! And thank you po sa pag-sponsor ng ating mga papremyo. Siyempre, pinagdadasal namin na, na sana po ay mabigyan pa kayo ng mas maraming blessings. Okay, so sa araw na ito, partner, magkakaroon na naman tayo ng isa pang live streaming mula sa ating math learning area ng grade 8. Okay, kaya naman, huwag na nating patagalin. Okay, so para samahan tayo, pakilala mo na partner okay. Ang ating mga learning facilitators.
So, introduce lang natin sila, no? So, isa-isa silang babati mamaya sa kanya-kanya nilang mga eksena dyan. O, diba? Good morning po ang ating mga learning facilitators today. Teacher Lori Lee Venitura and Teacher Janice Bills A. Simone. And of course, kasama din po natin dito ngayon sa loob, Teacher Judith S. Gamilo and Teacher Mylene J. Ralutien para sa ating iba't ibang bahagi pa ng programa. Shout out po sa aming supportive head teacher, Mami! Nandito na naman kami, Ma'am Merlinda D. Dante and pabati na rin, ano, si Ma'am Ruby R. Guillermo, ating assistant principal and kay Sir Rodrigo V. Pascua, our Chief Education Supervisor Officer in charge. Good morning po sa inyong lahat. Ayan. Please comment your name and section at isend niyo sa inyong mga kanya-kanyang group chats sa bawat bahagi ng ating programa para naman makita ng mga teachers nyo na nandyan lang kayo sa pamamagitan ng comment section. Okay.
Yeah.
Our lesson today is all about describing the graph of the linear equation. Ano bang objectives natin ngayon?
Okay,
partner?
So ayan partner, meron tayong apat na objectives.
Yes, ano kaya
okay.
Yung
so kung ikaw ang tatanungin ko partner, wow. Paano mo naman i-describe ang slope ng love?
Why? May ganun pala.
Kasi most on the topics today is all about the slope, yung trend.
Sige.
So kapag love naman ang pinag-uusapan, ano naman ang trend?
Wow, trending talaga ito. Trend daw. Okay, ano ba yun? Sige ka, ikaw nga.
Di ba ang love, kapag umpisa, ang taas?
Ay, in fairness, oo.
Kapag
tama.
Nagtatagal, lumalamig ba yan? Lumababa. So, ang slope niya, going down.
Oh my God, ang saya naman.
Pero hindi dapat ganun. Dapat, going up.
Yeah.
So, eto na ang ating mga objectives. Meron tayong apat. Okay, number one, determine the slope of the linear Determine the slope of the linear equations given the graphs. Number two, describe the trends of the graph of linear equation in terms of the slope and intercept.
Yes, at meron din tayong objective dito, describe the trend of the graph given the equations. And yung huli, relate the graph of linear equations in real-life situations. Makarelate yun talaga.
Oo, kaya makarelate talaga yan.
Yes. So, wag na wag po kayong aalis mga anak, ano? Magbabalik kami, katulad ng inaabangan yung laro natin, ano? Meron tayo ulit pahula today.
Yes.
So, baka ba kayo after RBI natin, ano? So, ito na po, ihahatid na namin sa inyo ang ating RBI lesson. Please listen, get your learning activity sheets and take note. Yes, makinig kayo at kami po ay magbabalik.
Huwag kayong aalis.
Yes.
Wala nang makakapigil pa. Sulong Arangkada 106.3 Dance Radio sa Aurora, Isabela.
Edukasyon sa sulong, basta na magtulong-tulong. Sulong edukalidad, Dance Radio.
Calculus,
Advanced Algebra,
Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry,
Elementary Algebra,
Geometry. Mga aralin na dapat tuklasin.
Mathematics Learning Area.
Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan.
Mathematics, maaasahan.
Inyong tututukan dito sa
106.3
Dance Radio.
Learning is amazing!
Blessed day to our dear listeners, especially to our grade 8 students. Today, enjoy the miracles of this beautiful day and let them fill your heart with joy. Make it a habit to tune in to our station, 106.3 FM, Dance Radio. I am your radio teacher for today, Teacher Rowella S. Santos. How are you feeling today? I hope you are in a comfortable place while listening to your radio. I expect that you have with you your Math 8 modules, Week 4, together with your paper and pen. If not yet, please get them now, for you will need them as we proceed to our lesson. If you have any questions about our lesson, you may call or message your teacher in Mathematics 8. Let us start today with these 3 life rules by an unknown author. If you don't go after what you want, you'll never have it. If you don't ask, the answer will always be no. If you don't step forward, you will always be in the same place. Welcome to our lesson in Mathematics 8, describing the graph of a linear equation. Let us begin by reviewing graphing linear equation. Who can give one of the methods of graphing linear equation?
Ma'am, one of the methods of graphing a linear equation is using any 2 points.
Very good! How do you find the 2 points in linear equation y equals 2x minus 3?
Ma'am, assign any 2 arbitrary values of x, say 0 and 1, and then solve for the corresponding values of y.
Very good! What else?
Ma'am, by substitution, y is equal to 2x minus 3. When x is equal to 0, then y is equal to 2 times 0 minus 3. So, the value of y is equal to negative 3.
That is right! What about the other value of y?
Ma'am, by substitution, y is equal to 2x minus 3. When x is equal to 1, then y is equal to 2 times 1 minus 3. So the value of y is equal to negative 1.
You are right. The value of y after substituting the values of x with 0 and 1 are negative 3 and negative 1. By using the two ordered pairs 0, comma negative 3 and 1, comma negative 1, we can now graph the line y equals 2x minus 3. Where can we find 0, comma negative 3?
Ma'am, 0, comma negative 3 lies along y-axis below the x-axis.
Yes, you got it right. 0, comma negative 3 lies along the y-axis below the x-axis. What about 1, comma negative 1? Where can we find it?
Ma'am, 1, comma negative 1 is located in the fourth quadrant.
Very good. If you will connect the two points, what did you form and why? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, it's a straight line because two points determine a line.
That's nice, dear learners. You can still remember your lesson in geometry. Today, my dear learners, we will determine the different trends of the graph of a linear equation. Describe the trends of the graph of a linear equation in terms of its intercepts and slope, and relate the graph of linear equations in real-life situations. My dear learners, have you tried mountain climbing?
Not yet, ma'am.
How about a coconut tree? Have you tried climbing a coconut tree? Will you describe it?
Ma'am, it's very difficult and I need to tighten my grip so that I will not slide down.
Oh, it's really difficult then. How about using a ladder in climbing a coconut tree to get young coconut? Is it easier for you to climb it? Why?
It is easier to climb a coconut tree using a ladder because the ladder is inclined, ma'am.
Yes, that's true. Do you agree, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am.
Your shared experience serves as a real-life example of our lesson for today about the different trends of the graph of a linear equation in terms of its intercepts and slope. Can you still remember the slope of a line?
Yes, ma'am. A slope of a line is a number that describes both the direction and the steepness of the line.
Yes, dear learners. A slope of a line is a number that describes both the direction and the steepness of the line. A slope can also be described as rise over run. There are four steps in finding the slope from a graph. Who can give the first two steps?
Ma'am, the first two steps are to locate two points on the line whose coordinates are integers and sketch a right triangle going from the first point to the second point.
Thank you, dear learner. How about the other two steps? Can you give them?
Ma'am, the last two steps are count the rise and run on the legs of the triangle and take the ratio of the change in y and change in x.
Thank you, dear learner. Now, let us describe the four trends of the graph of linear equations.
Let's go!
Okay, who can describe the first trend?
Ma'am, if the slope is positive, then the graph is increasing from left to right.
Yes, that is correct. If the slope is positive, then the graph is increasing from left to right. How about the next trend?
Ma'am, if the slope is negative, then the graph is decreasing from left to right.
Yes, that is right. If the slope is negative, then the graph is decreasing from left to right. Who can give the third trend?
Ma'am, if the slope is zero, then the graph is a horizontal line.
Very good. If the slope is 0, then the graph is a horizontal line. What about the last trend?
Ma'am, if the slope is undefined, then the graph is a vertical line.
That's correct. If the slope is undefined, then the graph is vertical line. Thank you, dear learners, for your active participation. Let us pause for a short reminder.
Naku, malapit na ang pasahan ng outputs.
Ha, retrieval time na naman. Narito ang mga dapat mong tandaan sa pagpasa ng outputs mo, Kadonyan.
Tiyaking nakasulat ang iyong pangalan sa bawat subject na iyong ipapasa.
Oops, huwag ding kalimutang isulat ang iyong seksyon kung saan ka kabilang.
Mahalagang lagyan din ng label na week 1,
week 2, 3, o 4 ang iyong outputs kung anong aralin.
At bilang nito upang malaman ng guro kung kumpleto ang iyong ipinasang outputs sa bawat linggo. Kadonyan!
Maaari, isulat din ang pangalan ng iyong guro sa bawat subject.
Kung may color coding, sundin ito upang madaling malaman ng iyong advisor at maibigay sa tamang guro.
Paghiwalayin ang mga sagotang papel sa bawat subject.
Huwag paghaluin ang iyong mga sagot sa dalawang subject sa iisang papel.
Kung masusunod mo ang mga ito, tiyak ang mga guro ay hindi malilito.
Sa pagpasa ng mga outputs, tiyaking maayos at organisado.
Ayusin ang output batay sa mga sumusunod na bawat aralin.
Una, sagot ng mga gawain. Pangalawa, reflection.
Pangatlo, lingkuhang pagtataya.
At pangapat, summative test kung mayroon.
Isang paalala mula sa pamunuan ng Doña Aurora National High School at ng istasyong ito.
We're back! Now, let us describe the trends of a graph of a linear equation in terms of its intercepts and slope.
Let's go!
Can you still remember the slope-intercept form of the equation of a line?
Yes, ma'am. The slope-intercept of the equation of a line is y is equal to mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept.
Wow! You have a very sharp memory. Yes, the slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. On page 9 of your learning activity sheets, example number 1, how will you describe the graph of the linear equation y equals 3x minus 2?
Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, in the graph, y increases as x increases, so the line slopes upwards to the right.
That's a very good description. In the graph, if y increases as x increases, then the line slopes upward to the right. What did you notice about the slope?
Ma'am, I noticed that the equation has a positive slope, that is 3.
That's nice observation, dear learner. If the equation has a positive slope, then the graph of the given equation increases from left to right. Can you follow, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
That's nice to hear. Let us have the graph of the linear equation y equals negative 2x plus 3 on page 10. Who can describe the graph of the linear equation y equals negative 2x plus 3?
Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, in the graph, y decreases as x increases.
If y decreases as x increases, what can you say about the line's slope?
Ma'am, if y decreases as x increases, so the line slopes downwards to the right.
And what did you notice about its slope?
Ma'am, I noticed that the equation has a negative slope, that is negative 2.
What can you conclude now, dear learners?
Ma'am, I can conclude that the graph of the given equation decreases from left to right.
Wow, you are correct. If the slope is negative, then the graph of the given linear equation decreases from left to right. Now, let us describe the trend of the graph given the equation. On page 11, under What's More. In this activity, you need to identify the sign of the slope and then describe the trend of the graph. Are you ready, my dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Okay, number 1. Y equals negative 3/5 x plus 4. What is the sign of the slope of a line and trend of the graph of y equals negative 3/5 x plus 4? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the slope of the line is negative 3/5 and the sign of the slope is negative. So the trend of the graph is decreasing from left to right.
Yes, you're right. The trend of the graph is decreasing from left to right when the sign of the slope is negative. Let us have number 2. Y equals negative 9. What is the sign of the slope of the line and the trend of the graph given the equation y equals negative 9? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the slope of the line is 0 and negative 9 is the y-intercept, so y does not change as x increases. Then, the trend of the graph is exactly horizontal.
Perfect! The trend of the graph is exactly horizontal when the slope is 0 and y-intercept is negative, and so y does not change as x increases. Now, let us move on to number 3. Y equals 4x minus 3/2. What is the sign of the slope of the line and the trend of the graph given the equation y equals 4x minus 3/2? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the slope of the line is 4 and the sign of the slope is positive. So, the trend of the graph is increasing from left to right.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. The trend of the graph is increasing from left to right because the slope of the line is positive. How about number 4? X equals negative 2. What is the sign of the slope of the line and the trend of the graph given the equation x equals negative 2? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, an equation of the form x is equal to negative 2, where negative 2 is the x-intercept, then the graph is a vertical line, and when the line is exactly vertical, it does not have a defined slope.
Magnificent! You really have a good reasoning power. And I like that. If the given equation is only the x-intercept, the graph of the line is exactly a vertical line. Then, it does not have a defined slope. Did you get it, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Thank you, dear learners! Let's have a short break before we have a wrap-up of today's activities.
Facts about COVID-19. What is COVID-19? COVID-19 is a disease caused by a new strain of coronavirus. What are symptoms of COVID-19? Symptoms can include fever, cough, and shortness of breath. In more severe cases, infection can cause pneumonia or breathing difficulties. How can we prevent COVID-19? To prevent the spread of COVID-19, clean your hand often. Maintain a safe distance. Wear masks when physical distancing is not possible. Don't touch your eyes, nose, or mouth. Cover your nose and mouth with your bent elbow or a tissue when you cough or sneeze. Stay home when you feel unwell, and if you have a fever, cough, and difficulty breathing, seek medical attention. This health advisory is brought to you by World Health Organization, Doña Aurora National High School, and this station.
We're back! Let us have a recap of today's lesson. Remember, dear learners, that the value of the slope tells the trend of the graph of a linear equation. So, what are the trends of the graph of a linear equation?
Ma'am, if the slope of a graph is positive, then the graph is increasing from left to right.
Very good! What else?
Ma'am, if the slope is negative, then the graph is decreasing from left to right.
Exactly! Any more?
Ma'am, if the slope is zero, then the graph is a horizontal line.
You are correct! What else?
Ma'am, if the slope is undefined, then the graph is a vertical line.
Congratulations, dear learners! You are really very active. Continue your good job! To further understand the lesson, let us relate the graph of linear equations to a real-life situation. For example, in the kitchen, if the ingredients in making a cake are 1/2 cup of butter, 2 cups of flour, 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder, 3 eggs, and 1 cup of sugar and milk, what would be the measurements of the ingredients for the 2 cakes?
Ma'am, I will double the ingredients of 1 cake, so 1 cup of butter, 4 cups of flour, 1.5 teaspoon of baking powder, 6 eggs, and 2 cups of sugar and milk.
Yes, dear learner! When you double the ingredients, you apply a linear equation.
Wow! It's really linear!
Yes, it's really linear! Now, let's have another example. If a balot vendor spends 200 pesos as initial capital and earns 150 pesos per week, can you predict his cumulative profits from week to week for 6 weeks? What would be the linear equation?
Ma'am, y is equal to 150x minus 200, where 150 is the weekly earnings, x is the number of weeks, and 200 is the initial capital.
That is correct. The linear equation is y equals 150x minus 200. How much is his earnings after 6 weeks? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, 700 pesos.
Did you get the same answer, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
How did you get 700 pesos? Anyone who can explain it?
Ma'am, I substituted the number of weeks, which is 6, to the linear equation. I got y is equal to 150 times 6 minus 200. Simplifying it, 150 times 6 equals 900 minus 200 equals 700.
Fantastic! I hope you learned a lot from our lesson. Please continue answering the different activities in your last or learning activity sheets and try to reflect on the lessons you have learned in this session. You also need to answer the weekly validating questions and summative tests. Is it clear, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Wow, we're done! As we end our session today, I would like to acknowledge the teachers behind this RBI lesson. Teacher Mylene J. Relutin, our scriptwriter. Teacher Rufino R. Pumeda Jr., our technical specialist. Teacher Jonna A. Buduan, our language editor. Ma'am Merlinda D. Dante, Head Teacher 5, Mathematics Learning Area, our content editor. And I am Teacher Rowella S. Santos, your radio teacher. Thank you very much and stay tuned in for our live discussion coming up next. I leave you this quote by Israel Moore, Ivor. Life is a linear equation in which you can't cross-multiply. If you think you can do it, you can do it. If you think you can't do it, you can't do it. It's a simple formula. God bless everyone. Stay safe. Goodbye.
Precalculus.
Advanced Algebra.
Intermediate Algebra. Trigonometry.
Elementary Algebra.
Geometry. Mga aralin na dapat tuklasin.
Mathematics Learning Area.
Mathematics. Kahit saan, kahit kailan.
Mathematics, maaasahan.
Inyong tututukan dito sa
106.3
Dance Radio.
Learning is amazing!
Wala nang makakapigil pa. Sulong Arangkada 106.3 Dance Radio sa Aurora, Isabela.
Edukasyon sa sulong, sana magtulong-tulong. Sulong itong kalidad. Dance Radio.
Diba?
Salamat po sa patuloy na panonood hanggang ngayon, ano, sa ating mga anak na patuloy na nagko-comment sa ating comment sections. Okay. So bago tayo mag-proceed sa ating discussion part 1, sabi ko sa inyo kanina, maglalaro muna tayo ng konting-konti. Okay. Hula mo, load mo. Okay, eto na ang mahiwagang box. Okay. Ngayon, ibibigay ko yung tamang template, mga anak, ano, para mapili namin kung sino yung unang 10.
First 10.
First 10 correct entries ang pipiliin namin at iroroleta na lang natin para mas makita ninyo na talagang yung pagka-select sa kanila ay maayos na maayos. Okay. So, please type name, section, hula 1, and their cell phone number to our comment section. Okay, again, ulitin ko ha, kailangan kompleto po ito, template na ito, para mas mabilis namin makita yung message. Huwag yung basta name, sagot, din. Medyo malabo kasi baka mabilis ang path. At least kung meron yung sinend ko dyan ngayon na template, yan ang gamitin ninyo. Include yung word and name, and then yung name mo.
Oh, dapat mas kompleto. Oo,
kompleto talaga. Yun yung factor doon, ano? Use the complete template. Again, bago tayo mag-proceed, salamat sa Star Sharer. Si Ate Mardy, hello! Andiyan ka ngayon, no? Diba?
Ma'am Mardy!
Yes! Eto, Miss Carnate, nag-share ng 100 stars.
Wow! Bomba.
At sa mga nanonood dyan sa Bagnos Integrated School, good
Shout
morning!
Shout out sa mga taga-Bagnos!
Bagnos!
Hello, Bagnos!
Okay! Baganito ito. So, okay.
Bawal mag-vlog.
Go, go, go! Hula na! O, diba? So, titignan natin. Ano
bigay
ng clue,
partner?
Ginagamit ulit. O, diba?
Yes.
Ginagamit lalo na ng mga batang nakikinig ngayon.
Yes. Sa mga mag-aaral.
Yes. Pwede gamitin din ito ng mga matanda, actually.
Oo naman.
Sa bahay, pwede rin itong gamitin. Mm-hmm.
Kung nanay, pwede gamitin yan.
Pwede rin. Oo. Alam ko yun. Sige. Na-curious kayo kung bakit yung nanay talaga. Sige. Hula na mga anak na comment ng comment. Ayan. So, ang dami nagko-comment na.
Alugin mo, partner, para makita.
So, naaalug siya. Medyo mas mabigat ako sa kanya, siyempre.
Konti lang yung tunog niya.
Konti lang at tunog. Okay. Tingin tayo ang comments, ano? Okay, meron ng humula. Headset daw. Sige, comment lang ng comment kasi hindi namin sasabihin agad yung correct answer until may 10 pumasok na correct answers. So, may humula ng headset. Cellphone.
Headphone.
Okay, radio. Headset. Hula 1, si Venice Riola, wala siyang sagot. Nilagay niya lang yung hula 1, pero wala siyang hinula. Okay.
Nakalimutan niya yung type partner.
Oh, mukhang kailangan na natin magbigay ng another clue, partner.
Okay, ito ay straight siya. Tuwid na tuwid.
Oh my God, straight talaga. Doon tayo sa daang tuwid.
Daang na tuwid.
Okay. Ano mga bagay ang straight dyan? Sige. Saya. Headset ulit. Sige. Cellphone. Headphone.
Glasses.
Okay.
Math module.
Puro cellphone, ano?
Ruler.
Okay. May nag-comment.
Ruler. May pencil. Mga sige. Straight na bagay ito. Ruler. Uh-huh. Ayan.
Sige. Mabagal yata. Okay.
Ayan. May, so, may nakita ako dalawa.
Oo. Sige. Ibig sabihin, meron na kaming nakita correct answer, ano?
Okay. Apat.
So, sige. Comment lang ng comment. Naghihintay. Nabasa na namin yung correct answer, ano? Yun ang clue, ah. Pero, hintay tayo pumasok yung sample.
Dali lang, ma'am. Pito.
Yes. Okay. May nabilang
walo.
Na.
Walo.
Okay.
Siyam.
Yan. Sige, comment
okay,
lang yung
10 na. 10 na siya.
Okay, yung mga pangalan, ma'am, take note natin para sa maswerteng makukuha. Okay? Okay?
Wala naman pinatating
sa akin. Sige, comment lang ng comment. Ano, bine-verify lang namin kasi mag-isa ang ating...
Sige, ma'am, mag-back-read kami.
Sige,
ito pa na.
Okay. So, habang kami ay nagseselect ng maswerteng mananalo para sa ating hulawan, ibibigay na namin ang correct answer.
Oh, ano ba ang
tamad ng ating...
Ang correct answer ay kailangan nyo makita, syempre.
So, mamaya pagbalik namin dito, magro-roleta tayo para sa mananalo dyan. Syempre, kukunin namin talaga yung first 10. Okay. Ang maswerteng nakahula ay 10. Mahigit 10 actually, pero first 10.
10 matutuwid ang hula.
Ano kaya yung straight na bagay na ginagamit ng mga mag-aaral na nakikinig at pwede rin sa nanay daw?
Yes, pwede sa nanay.
Okay, ano ayan. To? Oh, diba? Tumahimik ka din. Hindi ka
na upo na. Tuwid siya. Hindi siya pwedeng ano. Hindi
okay.
Straight.
Ruler. So, congratulations sa mga nag-comment ng ruler. Abangan nyo sa amin pagbabalik ang ruleta natin. Okay? So,
ano ka muna, ma'am? Mag-out
okay.
Ka tapos mag-in.
Magbabalik tayo. Hulawan pa lang yan, ano? So, bago tayo magpatuloy sa pagpili ng ating maswerteng mga nakapag-comment ng correct answers, ibibigay na ba natin ang unang tanong?
Yes, partner. Ibigay na natin ang official
natin
number one
unang
question.
Tanong dyan.
Ito ay worth
30
pesos.
Yes.
Load.
Yes.
Okay.
So, hindi, sa mga hindi nakahula kanina, Bito, baka may chance kayo.
Ayan. Ano so, ito na ang ating question number one.
Yes.
Ayan, tingin kayo sa screen, mga anak, ha. What is the slope of the line? Letter A, 3/4. B, -3/4. Letter C, 4/3. And letter D, -4/3.
Okay.
I repeat, what is the slope of the line? Letter A, 3/4. B, -3/4. Letter C, 4/3. And letter D, -4/3.
Okay, ayan. Isinend ko na ngayon mga anak ang template na kailangan nyong gamitin. Of course, please comment your name. Ilagay nyo muna yung name, then pangalan mo. Section mo. Question number one para ma-indicate kung anong tanong ang sinasagot mo ngayon. And of course, your answer, kung anong letter yung sagot mo, and then cellphone number. Okay, makinig kayo na para mas maintindihan nyo kung paano yan sasagutin. So, huwag na natin patagalin, partner. Tawagin na natin, prepared siya kagabi pa. Okay, let's welcome ang napakagaling nating facilitator. Good morning, Ma'am Lorelie Vinitura. Go, go, go!
Sa dulo ka.
pa ako? Ma'am Ella, naririnig po? Okay. Hello everyone, good morning. I am so pleased to be with you again today. Greetings to all my grade 8 learners, 8 tangerine and 8 purple. Makinig at makiparticipate sana kayo mga anak. Binabati ko rin ang aking mga grade 7 learners, 7 Samora at 7 Sulaiman. Kagaya ng sinabi ni Ma'am Ella, kung may bakanting oras kayo mga anak, pwede kayong makinig para madagdagan pa ang inyong kaalaman sa Math 8. Okay, let us start. Today, we are going to discuss how to determine the slope of a line given the graph. Describe the trends of the graph based on its y-intercept and slope and linear equation. Okay, let us start by defining first the slope. A line can be described by its slope. The slope of a line is a number that measures its steepness, usually denoted by a small italic letter M. It refers to the change in Y for a unit change in X along the Y. Sa ating paligid, may mga bagay na merong slope. Kagaya ng nabanggit kanina sa una, ang hagdan ay may slope. Ang ating mga bubong sa bahay, bundok, kung ito ay mas matarik, yun ay mas malaki ang slope. At kung mas flat, yun ay mas may mababang slope. In mathematics, meron tayong formula to determine the slope of a line. Let us have the first example. Given the graph with two distinct points, point 1, negative 4 and 0, point 2, 0 and 3. Using the formula, change in y over corresponding change in x. When we say change in y, we are going to have the difference from y1 to y2. All over the change in x, the difference between x sub 1 and x sub 2 or vice versa. Let us substitute the formula, the given points in the formula. In point 1, our y sub 1 is 0 and our y sub 2 in point 2 is 3. So 0 minus 3. All over, our x sub 1 is negative 4 and our x sub 2 is 0. Simplifying it, 0 minus 3 is equal to negative 3. Negative 4 minus 0 is equal to negative 4. Negative 3 all over negative 4 in simplified form is equal to 3/4. So our slope is 3/4. Another formula to determine the slope of a line is by the ratio of rise over run. When you say rise, it refers to the vertical distance, and run refers to the horizontal distance. So in the formula, in the graph, we count how many units na nagtumaas yung ating graph from point 1 to point 2. So 1, 2, 3. Run, ilang units going to the right ang ating graph. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So using the ratio, 3/4. Pwede naman yung point 2 pababa sa point 1. Kung pababa, papunta sa point 1, bababa tayo ng 3 units. Then going to the left, apat na units. So negative over negative is positive 3/4 pa rin. So the trend of the graph is increasing. So when the slope is positive, the graph of the line increases or rises from left to right. Naintindihan po ba? Okay, let us have another example. Another graph with two distinct points, point 1, negative 3, 0, and point 2, 0, negative 3. Substituting in the formula again, for our y sub 1, 0, our y sub 2, negative 3, our x sub 1, negative 3, and our x sub 2, 0. Okay, I hope alam nyo kung saan ninyo nakukuha yung mga points na ilalagay natin sa formula. Pwede rin namang y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Okay, simplifying this, 0 minus negative 3, applying integers or subtraction of integers, so change the sign of the subtrahend negative 3 into its opposite, then proceed to addition. So this will become 0 plus 3 equals 3, negative 3 minus 0 is equal to negative 3. 3 divided by negative 3 is equal to negative 1. So our slope is negative 1. Now applying again, rise over run. Going point 1, going to point 2, we are going to go down 3 units and go to the right 3 units. So, negative 3 over positive 3. So, to get the slope, you simplify, it is also negative 1. So, slope is negative if the graph of the line decreases or it falls from left to right. Makikita nyo the graph from left up going down to the right. Kahit saan quadrant po ito nakalocate. Kahit dito sa first quadrant, basta from left going down to the right, the slope is always negative. Let us have the third example. Okay. Given the graph of the line, point 1, negative 3, and point, point 1, negative 3, negative 3, and point 2, 3, negative 3. As you can see, it is a straight horizontal line. Now, let us have the formula first to determine the slope. So, substituting it, we have negative 3 minus negative 3 all over our x sub 1, negative 3, minus positive 3. Napansin nyo, walang pagbabago sa y1 saka y2. So, negative 3 minus negative 3. Again, you change the sign of the subtrahend. It will become positive, then proceed to addition. So, negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Negative 3 minus 3 is equal to negative 6. Now, what is 0 over negative 6? So, it is equal to 0. So, take note that the slope of a horizontal line is 0. Now, let us have the rise over run. Wala naman siyang paakyat o pababa na nangyari. So, 0 ang rise. Pero meron tayong horizontal distance na negative 6. So, still, the graph of horizontal line or the slope of horizontal line is 0. So, take note, slope is 0 if the graph of the line is a horizontal line. Okay. Let us have the last example. Okay, as you can see in the graph, we have a vertical line. Point 1, 3, 4, and point 2, 3, negative 4. You substitute the given points in the formula. X sub 1, y sub 1 is equal to 4, minus our y sub 2, negative 4. All over our x sub 1, positive 3, minus our x sub 2, positive 3. So, walang change sa x-axis. So positive 4 minus negative 4. Again, apply the subtraction of integers. So it will become 4 plus 4, which is equal to 8, all over 3 minus 3, 0. So 8 divided by 0. Napag-aralan natin nung nakaraang RBI na 8 divided by 0 is equal to undefined. So it cannot be. So we call it undefined. So the slope of a horizontal line is undefined. So dito makikita natin dahil kahit meron tayong vertical distance na 8, wala naman tayong pagbabagong naganap y sa x-axis. So, we cannot define any slope. So, slope is undefined if the graph of the line is a vertical line. Okay? Naintindihan po ba? Okay. Let us try this. Okay. So, let us try number one. What is the slope of line A based from the graph? Okay. Ito yung line A natin. So, wala tayong distinct two points dito. We will just determine. Pwede nating kunin yung point na nag-cross siya sa y-axis at yung point na nag-cross siya sa x-axis. We call this y-intercept, and pagka nag-cross siya sa x-axis, we call it x-intercept. Okay. So, how many units going to the second point? Bababa tayo ng ilang unit. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, bumaba tayo ng 9 units. Then, we go to the right. We go to the right. Dito yung reference na to. Dito naman, left siya kay Ma'am Judith. So, ilang units papunta sa point na ito? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, using the slope of a line rise over run, we go down negative, we go down 9 units, so that is negative 9, and we run to the right 7 units, so it's positive 7. So what is the slope of this line? Ipapahul ako, hindi na. So we have the slope of negative 9 over 7. Okay, let us have another line. Now, given line B. So, ano ang slope ng line B natin? It is a vertical line. So, what is the slope of a vertical line? Iko-comment pa ba ito sa ating chat box? Or we'll just reveal the answer?
Pwede rin, ma'am, para ma-check natin kung nakikinig sila.
Okay. Tingnan nga natin kung merong nakaalala. What is the slope of this line B, if it is a vertical line? Paki-comment nga sa chat box at tingnan namin kung sino ang... Yes, it's Nora Rosette. Undefined. Another? Meron bang ibang sagot? Undefined. Zarika. Aris Flores. Underline. Meron din nagtatagot ng underline. Kakaiba. Okay, so karamihan kay Zar, zero. So, ano ba talaga ang tamang sagot? Okay, so it is undefined. Always remember na pagka vertical line, the slope is undefined. Okay, next, number three. What is the slope of this line? Line C, a horizontal line. Again, paki-comment ulit sa chat box kung ano ang slope ng line C, a horizontal line. So, meron kay Ashlyn, undefined. O tsaka una pa lang yun?
Tidari lang ako. Okay.
Meron bang nag-answer? What is the slope of line C? A horizontal line, yes. Aslin, zero. Zar, zero. Jamie, zero. Thank you very much. The slope of line C is zero. Okay. Number, last example, number four. What is the slope of line D? Take note. O, mag-determine tayo ng dalawang point dito. Mas maganda kung kunin natin yung nag-cross siya sa y-axis para mas mabilis. Sa y-axis, let us have this point. Anong point ito? This is 0, negative 3. Sa x-axis, ito ay 1, 0. So, kung bibilangin natin from point 1 na 0, negative 3, aakyat tayo ng dalawa. So, it is the right, positive 2. Then, we go to the right, run to the right, 1. So, ang ratio niya ay 2 over 1. So, anong slope natin dito? So, it is equal to positive 2. A positive slope kasi from left, it goes up to the right. So, ano ang trend dito? Sinabi kanina, it is increasing. Pagka yung graph ay from left, going down to the right, negative, decreasing. If it is a vertical line, the slope is undefined. And if it is a horizontal line, the slope is zero. Naintindihan po ba? At huwag kakalimutan itong mga ito, mga anak. Okay, let us have the answer for question number one.
Ayan, thank you so
Ma'am
much,
Ella and Lord, Sir Ma'am Jane.
Diba? So mga anak, ano, ang ganda, kung gusto nyo, pwede nyong i-replay ito. Balikan nyo lang
technical
habang in-explain ni Ma'am Lloyd.
In the 2021 division online journey.
Mas malinaw na malinaw yung examples niya. At sana mamaya pag nag-discuss ulit, mag-comment kayo mga anak para makita naman natin na nakikinig kayo. Okay.
Yes, nabuhay pa. Nabuhay, yes. Nabuhay pa kayong nakikinig.
So balikan muna natin yung nanalo sa ating hula mo. Load mo. Mo. Ayan, ang mga... unang nag-send na nakita namin sa ating chat box ay nilagay natin sa ating magic roulette. At tingnan natin kung sino ang mapalad na nanalo bago tayo mag-proceed sa question 1. Okay, go, go, go.
Ating unang papremyo.
Ayan, for hula mo, load mo. Go, go, go. Hello, Czar. Go, go, go. Okay, ayan, natingnan natin. Sino kaya? Oh. May pumapalakpak na. Siguro may nanalo na. Sino kaya yung nasa pangalan? Okay, tingnan natin. Yung mapalad na nanalo for hula mo, load mo ay... Si... Sino yung pangalan okay. Dyan, ma?
Sino nanalo, ma?
Agata Mauricio. Okay, congratulations. Agata Mauricio. Medyo natakpan siya na sa likod yung pangalan. Agata Mauricio, congratulations!
Congrats.
Okay. So, ready na ba tayo, ma'am, para sa question 1 raffle? Okay, babalik kami ulit para sa pag-raffle. Ibigay na natin ang ikalawang tanong. Pwede namang sunod-sunod dyan na mag-raffle mamaya.
Anong answer okay. Sa question number 1,
okay,
partner?
Ang question number 1 kanina na ibinigay sa inyo, ang correct answer dito ay letter B. Yan, negative.
Letter B.
Yes, ma'am Lloyd?
Kasi, okay, it's letter B. Bakit letter B? Kasi from this point, 0, 3. Ay, sige.
Sige,
dito pa tayo, Ma'am Judith. Saan ba?
Yeah.
Okay.
The origin.
Dito sa origin. So, from the origin, umakyat tayo ng tatlong units.
Yes.
Pero,
tumakbo tayo
na. Mas maganda kasi kung nandito tayo sa point 1 na 0, 3. Bumaba tayo ng tatlong unit.
Okay.
So, negative. Pababa, negative. Then, we go to the right. 4 units. Moving to the right, run to the right means positive. Kung dito naman sa reference natin ito, umakyat tayo ng 3, pero we go to the left naman. Run to the left naman, kaya 3 over negative 4 is still negative 3 over 4. So the slope is the same.
So sana malinaw negative siya. Decreasing.
Kahit anong reference point natin dito, parehas ang slope na ibibigay.
Yes, negative siya. Okay, thank you ma'am. O yan, on, in-explain sa inyo ng maayos para mas malinaw sa inyo kung bakit naging negative 3 over 4 ang ating sagot. Okay na po.
Okay. Question number 2 na, partner.
So, ibigay muna natin ang question number 2 bago natin i-raffle ang ating question number 1 winner. Okay, para sa ikalawang tanong. Okay. Pakibasa sa inyong my screen, ano? Nandiyan na siya. What is the trend of the graph given the equation y equals negative 10? Again, what is the trend of the graph given the equation y equals negative 10? Kung nakinig kayo kanina at makikinig ulit kayo mamaya, masasagot niya yan. Okay, I think ready na tayo para i-raffle ang question number 1 winner. Okay,
yan, go. Ay,
ito kinahantay ko. Sino kaya? Okay, hintayin lang natin mga anak.
Hintayin natin,
ano?
Sir Joshua. Ayan.
Sige. Ayan. Okay.
Okay.
Sino kaya ang nanalo dyan? Yan, medyo nasa likod kasi siya. Press mo lang, ano. Okay, naglalag daw dito. Sige. Okay, congratulations.
Okay, congratulations. Camille Bulan.
Camille, ma'am? Camille?
Ramil Bulan.
Wow! Oh, medyo ibang mga pangalan. Ramil Bulan. Okay, congratulations, anak. Paki-message ang iyong subject teacher sa math na ikaw ang nanalo ngayon para sa details ng iyong load na tumatagiti na 30 pesos. Okay. So, sa question number 2, mga anak, same details tayo. Please comment your name, section, and then i-identify na question number 2 and then your answer, cell phone number para mapili at ma-verify namin ang inyong mga answers. Okay, wag na natin patagalin. Ituloy na natin ang second part of the discussion. Go, ma'am!
Okay. Let us have the next topic. Let us determine the trend of the graph based on its slope and y-intercept and based on its equation. So number 1, describe the trend of the graph of this equation y equals negative 3 5x plus 4. Na-mention kanina sa ating RBI lesson yung dalawang form ng equation of a line. Kung nakinig tayo, meron tayong tinatawag na standard form of linear equation and slope-intercept form of linear equation. Standard form is ax plus by equals c and slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. Dito sa first given na y is equal to negative 3 over 5x plus 4, this is in the form y equals mx plus b. Okay, wherein the coefficient of x, negative 3 fifth, is our slope, and the constant term 4 is our y-intercept. When you say y-intercept, you can locate that along the y-axis. So, it means the value of y where x is 0 or 0, 4. Okay, to determine the graph of this equation, let us first locate the y-intercept form. So, 4 is along the y-axis. 4, 0, 4. Okay, let us have the second point using the slope. Negative 3 over 5. In the ratio rise over run, yung rise pwede siyang pa-up or downward. So pagka negative, we go down. So negative 3. So from 4, we go down 3 units. So we have 1, 2, 3. And then yung denominator na 5 is run. Pagka positive, we run to the right. Pagka negative, we run to the left. Since positive 5, we run to the right. 5 units. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is our second point. Okay, so nakita ninyo, that is our second point. Connecting the two points, if we are going to connect the two points, this is now the graph of the equation y equals negative 3 fifth x plus 4. Now, based from the graph, what can you say? How will you describe the trend of the graph? So based dun sa previous lesson natin kanina, it's from left going down sa right. So what is the trend of the graph? It is decreasing, or it decreases from left to right. Since the slope is negative, negative 3/5, the trend of the graph is negative, decreases from left to right. Okay, next. Describe the trend of the graph of this equation. Negative 4x plus 4 equals negative 7. So, it is written, this is written in standard form. Ax plus by equals c. Now, we will first rewrite this equation into slope-intercept form, wherein sa left side, y lang ang maiiwan. So, tanggalin natin ang negative 4. How? Either we transpose to the right or we add its additive inverse. So, dito, we transpose to the right, kaya naging positive 4x. Pero, ang tamang solution niya, so negative 4x plus y equals negative 7 plus 4x, both sides, plus 4x. So, na-cancel na yung negative 4x saka 4x. So, naging y. 4x plus negative 4x is equal to 0. Okay. So, y now is equal to 4x. Okay, we are going to rearrange 4x minus 7. So, from this equation, we can now determine the slope and the y-intercept. The slope is the 4, the coefficient of x, and the y-intercept is negative 7. Unahin natin i-locate yung y-intercept na negative 7. So when we say y-intercept, it is along the y-axis, negative 7, so nasa baba. So ito yon. And then, yung slope of 4. Slope of 4 is a ratio of 4. Ano ang denominator natin dito? Pagka whole number. It is equal to 1. Take note mga anak. So, a whole number has a denominator of 1. So, this will become 4 over 1. So, it means we are going to go up 4 units. To locate the second point, we go up 4 units. And yung denominator nating 1, positive, we run to the right. So, we have run to the right 1 unit. So, nandun lang yung ating second point. So, if we are going to connect the two points, so this is now the graph of negative 4x plus y equals negative 7. Now, we can now describe the trend of the graph. What can you say about the trend of this graph? So, from left, it goes up to the right. So, this is increases, the graph increases from left to right. Since the slope is positive, so the graph increases from left to right. Naintindihan po ba, mga anak? I hope naintindihan ninyo. Let's proceed to the next example. Okay, now, let us have the equation 3x plus 3 and the graph. We are going to describe the trend of the graph. Now, how can we describe this graph? So, nakikita natin, we go up. So, y increases and x increases, right? So, as y increases, the value of x also increases. So, the line increases from left to right. From left to right, increasing. Okay, naintindihan po ba ito? Next, we have example number 2. Okay, next, equation is 2x minus y plus y equals 2. So, ano ang slope natin dito at ano yung y? Okay, from this point, 0, 2, ano ang napansin natin? O, sige, y is equal to, again, we eliminate 2x sa left. It will become, transpose natin, negative 2x plus 2. So, 2 ang ating y-intercept. So, along the y-axis, ang slope natin ay negative 2. So, negative 2 over 1 yan. So, meaning, we go down 2 units and we go to the right to 1 unit. So, anong napansin natin from left to right? Ang ating graph. Ano ang magiging description natin dito sa graph natin? So, as y decreases, ang x naman increases. In the graph, y decreases as x increases from left to right. Okay? So, this is a negative slope. Okay. Next, example number 3, given the graph, yung letter, yung kulay blue, y equals 3. A horizontal line. Kung ikokompleto natin itong equation na ito, y equals 3, ito ay y equals 0x plus 3. Zero slope. Diba? So, y is equal to 0x. 0x plus 3. Since 0 na yung coefficient ng x, kaya na-eliminate na siya, naging y plus 3. So, what is the slope of this? It is 0. So, what is the trend of this graph? Y equals 3. So, how can we describe this graph? Y equals 3? Okay, in the graph, y does not change. Steady lang kasi yung y natin as x increases. So, the line is exactly horizontal because the slope is 0. Okay. The trend of the line is horizontal because the slope is 0. Another line, itong red, x equals negative 2. So, dito, mapansin natin, hindi niya nasunod na yung y-intercept form. Wala tayong value ng y. So, meaning to say, this cannot be defined using the slope-intercept form of equation of a line. Vertical line. So, if it is a vertical line, the slope is not defined. So when the line is exactly vertical, it does not have a defined slope. So take note, mga anak. We call it undefined. Kasi walang change sa x. Okay? Let us try this. Okay, let us determine the slope or the trend of this equation. This should be y equals negative x plus 5. Sige, sandali lang. At i-check natin yung equation natin. Y, okay. Thank you, Ma'am Judith. Y equals negative x plus 5. Now, based from the equation, what can you say about the trend of the graph? Okay, very good. This is decreasing, or it decreases from left to right based from the slope na negative x. Ang coefficient niya ay negative 1. Negative 1. So, it decreases from left to right. Even without the graph, we can already say that this is decreasing because of the negative slope. Number 2. Okay, y is equal to 1 half x plus 2. So, what can you say about this graph or the equation y equals negative 2x plus 2? So, even without the graph, we can say that this line gives a trend of, okay, so it increases from left to right because of the positive slope. Okay, as y increases by 1 unit, x increases by 2 units. Yun yung ratio natin, 1 over 2. Next, number 3, y is equal to 2x plus 1. So, based again from the slope, 2, it is, the trend of the graph is increases from left to right. Paano yung increase niya? So, as y increases 2 unit, x also increases 1 unit from left to right. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng 2 over 1. Slope of 2, as y increases 2 units, x increases by 1 unit. Okay, number 4. X minus 2y equals negative 1. Ito ay nakasulat sa standard form. To determine the slope, we will first rewrite in slope-intercept form. So, we have to leave negative 2y sa left side and we will move x sa other side. So, it will become negative 2y negative 2y equals negative x minus 1. Since we only need y, so we are going to divide both sides by negative 2. Okay? Therefore, y is equal to, we simplify negative x by negative 2, it will be 1 or x. Sige. Okay? Simplifying negative 2 by negative 1 by negative 2, it will become 1 over 2 x. Again, negative 1 over negative 2, it will become positive 1 over 2. Okay. From this equation, we can already define or describe the trend of the graph based from the slope 1 half. Positive, so it increases from left to right. The increase will be 1 as y increases 1 unit, x increases by 2 units from left to right. Number 5. 3x plus 5y equals 8. So again, we do the same sa number 4. So, we eliminate 3x sa left side. We will move it to the right. So 5y is equal now to negative 3x plus 8. Again, divide by the coefficient of y 5. So this should be y only. So we will divide by 5. It will now become y equals, simplifying, negative 3 over 5 is negative 3/5. Negative 3/5x plus 8/5. Kung i-describe lang natin yung trend ng graph, based lang tayo sa equation of sa slope ng line. Negative 3/5. So what can we, how can we describe the graph? So it is, okay, it decreases from left to right. As y decreases by 3 units, x increases by 5 units. Ginagamit natin yung y-intercept, anak, if we draw the graph. 8/5. Okay? So, sana may naintindihan kayong sa ating lesson. Okay, I hope ready na tayo sa answer ng question number 2.
Okay, ang answer sa question number 2 at i-raffle natin mamaya pagsabay ng aking pamamaalam. Okay, ay correct answer is horizontal line. Sa mga nag-send ng correct answers, mamaya abangan niyo kung sino ang mananalo. Ibigay na natin ang panghuling salita kay Ma'am Janice. May pakonting dagdag lang siya. Konting-konti. Go.
Isa na lang.
Okay.
Ayan. So, saglit lang ito mga anak. Number problems tayo. So, first example tayo. The sum of two consecutive even numbers equals 38. So, kung isasolve po natin yan, we let x be the first consecutive even number. Then, x plus 2, the second consecutive number. So, sinabi kanina, the sum. So, we just need to add the two consecutive even numbers. So, we have x plus 2 equals 38. Solving, x plus x is 2x plus 2 equals 38. So, we have 2x equals 38 minus 2. Na-transpose yung positive 2 to the right side. So, we have 2x equals 36. Solving the value of x, we have 18. So, the first even number is 18 and the second consecutive even number is 20. Okay, so 18 plus 20, that is 38. Ayan, sa age problem tayo. Anne is 6 years older than her younger sister. After 10 years, the sum of their ages will be 50 years. Find their present ages. So, solution, we let x be the age of her sister, then x plus 6 be the age of Anne. Take note, si Anne ay mas matanda ng 6 na taon kay dun sa kapatid niya. So, pagkatapos ng 10 taon, mag-a-add tayo ng 10 sa ages nila. So, we have x plus 10, the age of her sister, then x plus 6 plus 10 be the age of Anne. So, the sum of their ages is 50. So, yung solution natin, we have x plus 10 plus x plus 6 plus 10 equals 50. Solving, we have 2x equals 50 minus 26. Saan nakuha yung 26? Sa 10 plus 6 plus 10. So, i-transpose natin sa right side, we have, magiging negative 26 siya. So, we have now 2x equals 50 minus 26 is 24. Dividing both sides of the equation by 2, we have x, which is 12. So, the age of the sister is, her sister is 12, then plus 10, so checking natin, 12 plus 10, that is 22, then after 10 years, that is 12 plus 6 plus 10, that is, or no, the age of Anne, I should say, that is 12 plus 6 plus 10, that is 28, so pag pinag-add natin yung ages ng dalawa, that is 50. Okay, so naihabol natin yung dalawang word problems. For the summary of our lesson for today, the value of the slope tells the trend of the graph of a linear equation. If the slope is positive, then the graph rises from left to right. And if the slope is negative, then the graph falls from left to right. Then, meron pa ba, ma'am? Ayaw. If the slope is zero, wala ayaw mag-focus sa ano, mag-flash. If the slope is zero, the graph is a horizontal line. Or if it is a horizontal line, the slope is zero. If the slope is undefined, the graph is a vertical line. Or if it is a vertical line, then the graph is undefined. Okay,
so ayan. Thank you so ayan. Much. Maraming salamat po sa pakikibahagi sa aming programa at sa ating lesson ngayong araw. Salamat sa ating facilitators, Teacher Lorelie Vinitura and Teacher Janice Bills A. Simon.
Thank you.
Salamat din po sa ating presentation designer and scriptwriter, DTI selector tayo na. Babe, basta may DTI. Teacher Mylene J. Ralutin.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, and of course, andyan din ang ating Aginja Jamboard. Teacher Judith S. Gamilo, maraming salamat. So habang nagpapakita tayo ng mga pasasalamat dito, pinaprepare ng mananalo, abangan nyo lang. And of course, sa ating...
Thank you din kay Sir Joshua Rason M. Guillermo, ang ating technical specialist. And syempre, maraming salamat sa ating quality assurance officer, Ma'am Marlinda D. Dante. Thank you so much, Mami. And syempre, salamat din po sa ating assistant principal, Ma'am Ruby R. Guillermo. And syempre naman, hindi natin kakalimutan ang ating chief education supervisor, officer in charge, Dr. Rodrigo V. Pascua. Thank you so much po sa inyong lahat.
Okay, ayan, pakishow na natin mamay ang ating lucky winner. Thank you so much for staying with us. Habang biniplay yan, ano? See you again next time. Kami po ang inyong naging host. My name is Teacher Rowella S. Santos.
And I am Teacher Jenny D. Carino.
Congratulations sa nanalo!
Sanjiro Ditura!
Ayan, nakita niyo, pinili talaga. See you again next time on...
Math Alive sa Facebook Live!
Thank you po, Sir
Thank Joss. You, bye-bye!
Sumobra na kayo 3 minuto.
Bye! Overtime kami!
See you on Friday!
Algebra, Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry, Elementary Algebra, Geometry. Mga aral na dapat tutusin. Mathematics learning area. Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan. Mathematics, maaasahan inyong tututukan dito sa 106.3 DWDR-FM. Basta Dance Radio, learning is amazing! Ito ang 106.3 Dance Radio. Dance Radio.
Prepare yourself.
Ang silid-aralan sa radyo, hating din ay matabalong paraan ng pagtuturo at kalaman. Mapaumaga, tanghali o hapon, ang istasyon magbibigay impormasyon kahit sa naman.
Look for something big.
Alright, here we go.
106.3 Dance Radio. Doña Aurora National High School, Santa Rita, Aurora, Isabela.
This
106.3 DWDR-FM.